Hi students, in today's session we are going to discuss about different categories of banks and electronic banking, advantages of electronic banking, different facets of the electronic banking. Okay, in the last session we discussed about what is a bank is. Bank is a financial institution which accepts deposits from the public and lending those deposits as a loans to the needy persons. And this activity is very important for the bankings. They are comes under the primary functions of the bank, accepting deposits and advancing loans. Okay. Banking sector plays a crucial role in the country's development because it giving several services to its customers. If a person wants to start its business organization, he has some proposal. If he execute that proposal, definitely he get succeeded in that project. But they don't have those financial resources to start the business. In such cases, if the person consult to the bank managers, then what happens? They may check the proposal. If that proposal is feasible, then they gives the loan to start the business organizations. Okay, here the entrepreneurial development also taking place with the services of the banks, right? And it plays a crucial role in the economy development also, right? So what are the different categories of a banks that we have, right? So write down these types of bank. Types of banks or the categories of the banks. The first type is commercial banks. Commercial banks. And next one is cooperative banks. And next one is specialized banks. And next one is central bank. Okay, it is a very easy topic to understand. The first category is commercial banks. The commercial banks performs the functions that are accepting deposits and advancing loans. Here the commercial banks are governed by Banking Regulation Act 1949. Commercial banks are governed by Banking Regulation Act 1949. Under this, the commercial banks are classified into two types. Commercial banks are classified into two types. Those are public sector banks and private sector banks. Public sector banks and private sector banks. In the public sector, the government have the major stake. The government plays a crucial role in the public sector banks. In such banks, the welfare is taken as the primary objective, not the profits. They consider the welfare of their customers as the primary objective in the public sector banks, in which the government has the major stake. And coming to the private sector banks, here these are operated by the private participation or the private persons or the individuals or they may be the group of individuals. So they can operate according to their rules. Of course, they have to consider the rules that are governed by the company or government. Though including those rules, they have their own rules, and they have to follow those rules. Okay, so example for public sector banks is like SBI, State Bank of India, and PNB, Punjab National Bank, in which the government has the major stake. Okay, coming to the private sector banks like ICICI, Kotak Mahindra, all these will comes under private sector banks. ICICI stands for Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India Limited. Okay, these are related to the commercial banks, which performs the functions of the banks like accepting deposits, advancing loans, credit creation, provision for payment systems, and behaving like an agent. All those functions are performed by the commercial banks. And next category is cooperative banks. Cooperative. We already know about the cooperative society, which is dependent on the principle of self-help and mutual help. Self-help and mutual help. Cooperative banks are works under the systems or then under the rules of State Cooperative Societies Act. State Cooperative Societies Act. This provides the benefits to its members, which means they are providing cheap loan facilities, which means here cheap loan means the interest rate is very low to its members. We know that already I told you that it is based on the self-help and mutual help. The benefits of this bank is derived for the members of certain bank. Okay, it was governed by the State Cooperative Societies Act. Then coming to the specialized banks. Here, the specialized banks are there for the certain category of the elements. For example, there are specialized banks in case of industrial development banks, exports and imports bank. Okay, all these categories will look after that specialized elements. For example, development banks, IDBI, SIDBI. Example, taking as example, IDBI stands for Industrial Development Bank of India, whereas SIDBI stands for Small Industrial Development Bank of India. These two provides the industrial sectors to provide funds for the development of industrial sector, small industrial development, and it is the organizational development funds are given to the needy persons. Here IDBI is a SIDBI is a subsidiary for IDBI. These are called as development banks. And like NABARD, it is to improve or provide loan facilities to the farming sections, and foreign exchange banks also there, and exports and imports bank, which is nothing but Exim Bank. These are the different types of banks which is specialized on that particular area. They provide services for those particular areas. Okay, and the next one is central bank. Central bank in any country plays a crucial role. It controls the activities or functions of the all the commercial banks that are prevailing in such country. Those are called as central banks, and it is also called as bank for the government, nothing but government bank. In India, what is the central bank? RBI, Reserve Bank of India. is behaves like a central bank and it gives the directions for all the commercial bank in India, and it announces interest rates, repo rates, and it introduces monetary policies. All those will activities which are done by the central bank. So once again, the categories of the banks are: first one, commercial banks. These commercial banks are governed by the rules of 1949, which are lies in the Banking Regulation Act, and according to that, commercial banks are divided into two types: public sector and private sector. Public sector banks, the major stake is belongs to the government, and in the private sector, management will takes place by the private persons. Cooperative banks, these are governed by the State Cooperative Societies Act. Here they provide cheap loan facilities to its members. And specialized banks, they provide specialized benefits to certain categories like development banks, exports and imports banks, foreign exchange banks, etc. Then central bank, it plays a key role, and RBI is the central bank for the India. So this is the classification of the banks. And the next topic is electronic banking. Next topic is electronic banking. So electronic banking, which is also known as e-banking. Here, the banking services that are provided to the customer is changing by way of time. That new technology and new adoptance to the technology will make changes in the bank services. In the earlier, if we want to withdraw certain amount from the bank, we have to go through the doorstep of the bank, and we have to wait on particular line, and we have to fill the form, which means withdrawal form, and we have to submit those form to the officials, and they may sit some time, we will call you, then we have to wait. So there is lot of time consuming processes there. Even we are depositing our currency in the bank, then also we are facing this much of procedures. But when the time is changing, when the technology is changing, then the time is to be reduced in the banking transactions. Okay, so which is because of the reason, that is the advancement of technology and adapting of the technology by the banks leads to the task very easier. Here, electronic banking means providing banking facilities to the customer's home, office, or their doorsteps. Here we are providing banking services at the customer doorsteps is called as e-banking. Okay, providing banking services to customer home or office by using electronic technology. By using electronic technology, here we are using the internet, we are using mobile banking, we are using some computers. Depending upon that electronic technology, our banking provides their services to the customer at their doorstep. It is a drastic change that appears in the banking services, and it starts when the introduction of computers takes place, when the introduction of the ATMs has taken place. and it also because of the email banking, tele banking and internet banking or online banking. Because of this reasons, the banks are giving their services to the customer at their home or office or their doorstep. Oh, nowadays there is no need to go to the bank to open a bank account. Simply by using our mobile phones, and we have to download a certain bank's app, and we can easily open our account in that particular bank. Even they are providing that services, particularly in the private sector banks are providing that. So there is lots of changes occurred because of electronic facilities that we have invented. That's why here what happens, the time gap between the services is reduced. The cost of services is reduced. The several many advantages has happened because of the electronic banking. Then what are the advantages? The first one is, you have to write down in your notes, right? Advantages of electronic banking. The first one is, it reduces the time gap. E-banking reduces the time gap. As already I told you, if we want to withdraw certain money from the bank, we are simply going to the ATM and where it is located, and we are inserting our card, entering by PIN, and we are getting cash. We are getting fast cash withdrawals by using ATM. Which means here the e-banking facilities is reduces the time gap between the banking services. And next advantage is prompt services. Prompt services. Here e-banking provides the prompt services to its customer. There is a trouble-free services. No need to worry about the transactions that are taken in the form of electronic, because they are all secured. So banks provides prompt services to its customers. And next one, anywhere, anytime banking. Anywhere and anytime banking. Anywhere and anytime, we can see our statement, bank statement, at any time when you are leisure, then you can see the bank statements even. So here the banks, because of electronic banking, the banks are working 24/7, which means 24 hours in a day and 7 days in a week. They are giving their services to the customers by way of electronic banking. And cashless transactions through the e-banking, we are need not to carry cash with us, because we are doing, handling cash is not necessary in the e-banking. We are doing the cashless transactions very easy. If we are going to some shopping mall, then whatever the requirements that we need to purchase, we are purchasing all those elements and we are simply swapping our card. We are not using the money there. So handling cash is not necessary in the e-banking. Okay. And providing secure services. And e-banking provides secure services to the customer. Here we need not to worry about the transactions that we are taking in the form of electronic. Right. So all these are the advantages of electronic banking, where the electronic banking means delivery of bank services to the customer at their home office or at their doorsteps. Okay, so the advantages of this is it reduces the time gap and it provides prompt services to the customer, and anywhere and anytime banking is possible because of e-banking facilities. We can get the information regarding our account at any time, 24 hours in a day and 7 days in a week. And there is a cashless transactions, we need not to carry cash with us, and it providing a secure services to the customer. So these are the advantages of the electronic banking. Then what are the different facets of the electronic banking is? Facets of the electronic banking. Electronic banking facets. First one is ATM. ATM. And next one is telebanking. Telebanking. And next one is online banking or network banking. Or internet banking, whatever it is. Okay. Online banking. And next facet is email banking. Email banking. And the next one is mobile banking. Till now it is very famous and all of you are using the mobile banking. It has several parts like SMS, short message sending by the banks, and GSM SIM toolkit, and WAP, wireless application protocol. These are the facets of the electronic banking. The first one is ATM. We are all know about ATM, right? Actually, ATM stands for automated teller machine. Automated teller machine, which is popularly known as anytime money machine. Anytime money machine. By using ATM, we can easily get fast cash withdrawals and transfer of funds, and we can deposit the cash into the bank. All these activities are done very fastly by using ATMs. Okay, we all know how the ATM is operated. If you are the customer of certain bank, that bank will provide you the card, which is maybe of debit card. Using the debit card, you have to go through where the ATM is operated, where the ATM is located. Then you simply go to that place and you insert your card and you enter the PIN number which is assigned to that particular card. And then you have to get the details of like your balance, and you can withdraw money and you can deposit the money into your account, or you can transfer the funds to another account holder. All these things are happens by way of ATMs. Okay, so here the ATM is located in several areas in the country. Then the master computer is located at the branch of the at the head office of the bank. So these are electronically joined. They are connected electronically. If certain operations are doing by using the ATM machine, it will appear to the master computers which is in the bank, which means it is a real time based transactions. Whatever the transactions that you are done by using the ATM machine is corresponding to your account is appeared clearly. For example, when you are withdrawing some amount, it will appear in the that system, which reflects your bank accounts. You have 10,000 of rupees of money in your account, you withdraw 5,000. Then that remaining 5,000 is to be deducted, the remaining 5,000 is to be shown as a balance, and remaining 5,000 is deducted as you are withdrawing from certain ATM machine. All these transactions are to be in the real time base. This is what about ATM is. ATM is also known as automated teller machine, which is also known as anytime money machines. And next facet is telebanking. Here we can get the information regarding our statements, regarding the payment of certain bills, regarding the purchase of certain securities. All these aspects will be done by telephone. We can check the balance of our account. We can check the statement of our account. All these transactions will take place by a single phone call, that is nothing but telebanking. It is one of the facet of the electronic banking. And the next one is online banking, also called as internet banking. It is very famous. If you have the network facilities or if you have the Wi-Fi facilities, by using that facilities you can do the banking activities. You can transfer funds, you can purchase certain products, you can pay through online, you can pay bill, insurance premiums, all these by using the online banking. Okay, so it is one of the facet of the electronic banking. And the next one is email banking. Here email, electronic mail. The bank sends the periodical statements to your email if your email is registered in that particular bank. They sends the statement, monthly statements to you. But here the email banking is not preferable in complex operations. You get only the statements and you can verify the statements by using the email banking. You need not to go the doorstep of the banks to know about the accounts details and the transactions that you are executed. Okay, it is one of the facet of electronic banking. Next, mobile banking. It is very famous nowadays. All we are having Android phones, touch phones, which is providing the opportunity to all the bank get the services of the banks in our hand, right? By using mobiles, if there is a certain app regarding to that particular bank, if you are installed that app, you can check your account balance at any time. You can check your statements regarding different activities that you are performed with regard to the bank. All these elements can be checked by a single click. Okay, so nowadays all banks are developing their personal apps to meet the customer needs. Even you can open an account by using a mobile phone. You can transfer funds, you can purchase products, and you can check the balances. Even you can apply for loan by using your mobile in certain cases of banks. So all these facilities will come under mobile banking. There are different kinds of mobile banking, like SMS, short message sending. When you are deducting amount from the bank or when you are withdrawing amount from the ATM machine, then the alert will send to the that particular customer personal phone. Here what happens, if there is an active and passive services, which means the active and passive services offered to the customer, the balance is shown to that particular customer. For example, if a customer is transferred 2000 rupees to the another person, then immediately he may get an SMS from that corresponding bank saying that you are transferred 2000 to some other person. The remaining balance is this, which is nothing but short message sendings by the part of mobile banking. And next one, GSM SIM toolkit. Here it is not available for the all customers. The customers who has the Android phones which supports the GSM SIM and who purchase the GSM SIM will have the benefits of this mobile banking. Okay, and next one, WAP, wireless application protocol. Whatever the screen that is displayed in the computer system, by using this wireless approval protocol, we can see that in our mobile phones. Okay, so these are the different elements that comes under mobile banking. So here, electronic banking means providing the banking services to the customer at his house, at his home, or at his office, wherever he wants. Right, the facets of the electronic banking is ATMs, telebanking, online banking, email banking and mobile banking. These are the different facets of the electronic banking. And here in nowadays, all the people are know about these electronic banking activities. Right, everyone is using GPay, phone pay, all these to transfer funds. Okay, even everyone has the corresponding apps regarding to the bank in their mobile phones. So they are the time gap between the transactions in which happens between banks and customers is reduced because of the electronic banking, and it also provides a secure protection to the customers, those who are using the electronic banking. So I think all of you are getting the class. Thank you.